order. I think this should be the house.
Is how you have failed to drum into your son's ear that there is and has always been a big dividing line between the rich and the poor.
That peasants associate with peasants and the bourgeois associate with the bourgeois. Or did you expect him to learn without being taught? I blame you that your son comes to our house to disturb our peace. I blame you for the love letters that your son writes my daughter. I blame you. Because if you had taught him to remain in his own poor part of the world, he would have accepted his place and remained there and not come to our own rich part of the world to disturb our peace.
Madam, actually, I don't blame you at all. Rather, I blame my son for all these insults you have heaped on me this morning. I'm not normally given to long speech, so I will not react. When my son comes back today, he and I will have a talk.
What could you possibly have to say when you so negligently avoid your responsibilities? Are you not aware that he has paid his school fees? Did you ask him how he got the money? Was it not half of the fees that you gave to him? Your son cunningly convinced my daughter to steal my money so that he can complete his school fees. I find that totally distasteful. He is a bad influence on her. She has never stolen anything in her entire life, because there's no need.
It is okay, madam. Madam, listen, listen. Have you come to my house to shout at me? Quarrel with me? Insult me? I will not quarrel with you. Huh? Like I said, once my son gets back today, we will talk.
Oh, better talk to him, and talk to him well. Because if I see him name my daughter, God help me, I will have him arrested and dumped in cell. And I promise he will not see daylight in a hurry.
In life, when a rich man walks down the road with seven live cockroaches, people will say he bought them. But if a poor man walks down the road with only one single, in fact, cockerel, he will stone him and say that he stole it. This is a speech as well as a proverb. My son, you have to stay away from that Dorothy girl. I know you like her, and I know she has not done anything wrong to you. But you must stay away from her and from the problems of her people. We don't have much. But the little we have is enough for us. I've been able to gather the remaining part of your fees. And I want to take it first thing tomorrow morning, go to their house and hand it over to the mother. That way the little respect we have will still be with us. I don't want you to feel bad. Your father is poor, yes? But not so poor as not to be able to train into any level of education you want. You will one day be a rich man. And many rich people want to be your friends. Remember this incident and try as much as possible not to discriminate against those who are not yet rich. The affairs of this world is like a dice. It swings from high to low and from low to high. A poor man today can be as rich as all the soldiers in Asia tomorrow. A rich man today can be a church rat tomorrow. Wipe your eyes and try to turn this insult to good by trying to become somebody tomorrow. Somebody be proud enough, strong enough, chest out, face front, to marry a girl stronger, better, richer than Dorothy. My son, I'm going out for a meeting of all the house agents in the area. It will be dark before I come back. But when I come back and you are still in the mood, we'll sit out there in front of the house where the moon rays shine brightest, and I will tell you a story. A story of how beautiful this world used to be when everybody was the same. When there were no rich men and no poor men. Until some idiots came to destroy the beauty of this world with the smell of the perfume. Stay well, son.
It's important, I need to tell you something. Bobo! Bobo!
How's the ball now?
Please come, I need to tell you something.
Baba said that he has given your mother the money you stole from her to pay for his school fees. What again do you want from us, eh?
Nah, pass go.
So well, you've told them about us, right?
Young love with young hearts, tender love tenderly grows, destined to be close to each other. Our love is wide like fire, admires each other, ready to die for each other. Shares our problems, shares our heartbreaks. Nothing can separate our love. Only if our feet move with our hearts, we'll be together in love.
Love you, I love you. You're my moon when it's dark. I love you from my heart. You're my rain when it's dry. You're the one my heart desires. We are made for each other. You are the love of my life.
Good morning, aunt. Good morning, class. How are you today?
Thank you.
Sit down, everybody. Well, before today's biology lesson, I have an important announcement to make to all of you. It's about our friend, your classmate, Dorathy Kings. I wish to announce to you that she is no more with us. That's our lesson for today.
What happened to Dorathy? Is she dead?
No, Bobo, no. Dorathy is not dead.
She has simply been withdrawn from this school to an all-girls school by her mother. That was what I meant when I said that she's no longer with us here. She's not dead, okay?
Find him, please. Find him.
Eat your food before it gets cold. Huh? Jollof rice is sweetest when it is warm.
I don't know if I'm hungry or not. It seems my stomach has found the knot inside.
Are you alright? What's the problem? Come on, Baba, talk to your father. Come on.
Papa.
Listen, Baba. Okay. I advised you to stay clear from Dorothy. Did you?
I did.
So what happened?
Nothing. Her mother has changed her from my school and put her in one all-girl school. That's what it is. See, Papa, I really do like Dorathy. Even though we don't talk anymore, but it felt good to see her in class every day. But now she's not going to be seen again.
My son, listen. Every man passes a broken heart along the line. And if he's lucky, he'll pass through it only once. But if he is unlucky, he'll pass through it as many times as he falls in love until he gets married and stops loving and then live in love with his wife. It is your turn to be hurt. Be strong. It will pass and you will love again. But remember, my son, your studies require a very large portion of your love because if you become a failure in life, all the Dorothys in this world will have nothing to do with you.
Papa, I thought you understand. That's why I always hide the love I have for Dorothy from you.
Oh, why wouldn't I understand? I fell in love with my first woman when I was 9. A girl called Ngozi.
What happened to her?
Can I remember now? It's a long time now. Maybe she's married to another person now.
Papa, did you love my mother?
Very much. Very much. But she died.
Yes, I killed her.
No, you did not kill your mother. Your mother died while giving birth to you.
I killed the only woman you finally loved. Maybe that's why I've lost my own now. I've lost Dorothy.
Don't say that, my boy. Don't ever say such things. You are still young. You are very young. And love will still come your way. Come on now, be a good boy, huh? Eat your food. Eat.
I'm still not hungry.
Dorothy! Dorothy!
Yes, Mommy?
Are you not starting to go to school? I'm ready to go to my office.
Are you ready?
You're ready? Like this? Where's your school bag?
Oh!
I don't understand you anymore. You know we have to drop you off before I go to my shop. Get your school bag and let's go.
I don't know what kind of forgetfulness this is.
I like Dorothy's new school. They start lessons on time, and the road to that place is always free. Not like a former school where the road is always jam-packed with vehicles.
The two schools are okay to me. You know, just that it's an all-commerce place. And I actually put her there because it was nearer the house. But this new one, it's classy, and not everyone can afford it.
Yeah. Dorothy. Dorothy.
What did she say?
She didn't say anything.
Dorothy!
Yes,
Dorothy!
Mommy.
What did you say?
I said nothing because I don't have to answer him. And even if I tell him I don't like the new school, you put me in another one.
Madam, shall I take just walk it first?
No, mind ya. Let's drop Dorothy first.
Better half.
I heard they are taking her to a school where you cannot afford. Boy, if I were in your shoes now, I would have been crying by now.
Not just a risk school, but in an all-girls school. Just remove her from Bobo's reach. Poor Bobo, if I were you, I would have gone straight to the president and reported how they took Dorothy My Love away from me.
Indeed, let him try it. The president will bring out his belt and whip him. And then ask him with this voice. Do you know it's a big disgrace to your village chief? You were asked to go to school to learn algebra. Instead of that, you went and learnt falling in love with Dorothy. What do you think the president will do?
Can you tell me that?
I think the president will whip his bum bum seriously and then
send it to work in the farm.
Mr. Lover.
What an idea.
There was once a foolish man who could not drink good water. Got it from a dirty pond and gave his wife and daughter. Now he starts weeping, weeping, weeping. Now he starts weeping. Oh, my wife and daughter. Oh, my wife and daughter. There was once a foolish man who could not drink good water. He got it from a dirty pond and gave his wife and daughter. Now he starts weeping, weeping, weeping. Now he starts weeping.
You're welcome, madam. Your daughter is a bright girl, but she gets absent-minded from time to time. And her teachers have complained several times to me. One time she's bright and intelligent, and the next moment she slips into a world of her own.
Lost in thought and far away from her classroom environment. At such particular time, when she suddenly asks a question, she jets back to reality, making it obvious that she was not paying attention all the while she was being taught and spoken to. So I decided to invite you to tell us if there's anything you know that is bothering her, so that we can help if there is any, because it's really affecting her studies.
Well, as far as I know, nothing is bothering her. Unless she's missing her old friends in her former school.
Then if the mere missing of her friends is making her behave like this, then you agree with me that it's a little extreme. What can we do to help the situation?
Don't worry, Mrs. Ayuba. I shall talk with my daughter, and in a short while this behavior will stop, I assure you.
Please do talk to her, because here in this school is of priceless importance to us to make sure that our students come to school every day, physically and psychologically ready to learn.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I have to be on my way now.
You're welcome.
Take care.
Thanks, eh?
Okay, all right.
Dorothy, barely 4 weeks in that school, I'm already being invited to discuss your matter.
What kind of rubbish is that now? Eh? Is there anything you lack? Good food, good clothing, good upbringing.
Do you go to fetch water from a public tap? Do you carry heavy buckets of water on your head like poor people's children do? Dorothy, do you go to hog akara or pure water? Dorothy, I give you the best. I love you. I pamper you. Whatever is your desire, it's my command. Eh? You go on holiday abroad. See, Dorothy. What is making you absent-minded in class? What is it that you lack? Tell me now, do you lack anything in this house? See, if you continue like this, you're going to end up with poor grades. Poor grades when I pay hundreds of thousands as school fees in that school. You had better wake up, Dorothy.
Mommy. I don't want to go to school anymore.
What did you say?
I said I am tired of going to school.
Good. Good! Let me clap for you. Yes! Don't go! I can see you want to frustrate all my efforts. Alright! Don't go! You hear? Don't! But one thing is certain. God, humanity, and the ground I stand on will bear me witness that I have done my best for you. Alright. Drop out, let me rest! You know what? Get prepared. I will buy you a big tray so that you start to hawk oranges, pure water, and maybe even akara. You know, the child that says its mother will not rest, will not rest. Stupid girl! Foolish girl! You want to kill me? I will give you rest!
Parents could not hear them apart. Threats could not even tear them apart. This is a natural law that no one was able to keep them apart. They are bound to be one. They are bound to be one. And no one was able to keep them apart. It is a natural law.
Come here, Didi. Whose food is this?
It's Dorothy's food. I even thought she has finished eating her food.
Does she know that you have put food for her since she returned from school?
Yes, madam, I told her.
I see. This girl is trying me. She will tell me the devil that has entered into her head this day. Excuse me.
Madam.
Yes, what is it?
Yes, I want to talk.
Is anything the matter?
No.
Is housekeeping money finished?
No, madam.
So what is it? Mercy, hurry up now. What is it?
Yes, madam. Why don't you wait? I observe she cries so much in her room these days. She's sad because of baseball. What is that his name? Bobo?
That's
very close. And she misses him so much. Please.
So because of a boy who lives in the slum, I will not have rest in my house. How long does Dorothy intend to continue like this? How long?
Madam, I'm a mother too. Children of our age are very attached to their friends. Male or female. That they even see you, the mother, as their worst enemy if you try to separate them from their friends.
So, I should encourage my daughter, who is barely 14, to have a boyfriend so that she can eat her food and concentrate on her studies?
Listen, madam. He's not her lover. He's just a friend to her. Definitely they are not doing anything, madam.
How can you tell? How can you tell, Mercy? If you don't stop it now, it might lead to something of shame later. That boy is 16 already. He is a man. He is a man. I know what I'm talking about.
No, madam. But I spoke with Dorothy. She confided in me. They're just innocent friends. And such friendship are very healthy for growing children, madam.
So what do you advise I do now?
Madam, you have to talk to her better. Buy her things that she likes, something like a bowl of ice cream. Be a mother to her, her friend, not a disciplinarian. Else she will grow to fear you. And she will not confide in you. And that's very dangerous, madam. Please.
I was thinking, I want us to have lunch, you know, go out for lunch this weekend.
Lunch? I don't need to be taking for lunch. I think I'm okay with the food at home.
Okay, if that's what you say. Sweetheart, I want to go to my room now, okay? I want you to think of a present, any present at all that you want me to buy for you, and it's yours for the asking. Come and tell me by this evening.
Yes, please.
All right. Okay, you take your siesta. Let me go to my room now. See you later.
Thank you. Bobo. Welcome.
Well, good morning.
It's day. Yeah, how are you?
Fine.
Mm-hmm. Sit down, my dear, sit down. Bobo. You've been very unhappy this past month. And I'm tired of seeing you unhappy. Now tell me the truth. You still do miss that girl, Dorothy, not? Not so?
Yes, Papa, I still miss her, but what can I do?
Listen, my boy. It is better to be bold than to cry. You're not a woman. Go to her house, knock at the gate. Tell them you want to see her. Nobody's going to beat you. Let your feet move with your heart. You'll be surprised I'm telling you all this, my son. I went through all this when I was as young, even younger than yourself. I broke many hearts. My heart was broken several times. You will break many hearts, not once, not twice. Your heart will be broken many times too, not once, not twice. Even when you get married, it will continue. Your wife will break your heart with her quarrels. You will break her heart with your utterances. But the key word is that you have to be firm. You might look foolish, but on the long run, you'll be a happy man. Do you understand me?
Yes, Papa. Thank you, Papa.
We've got something to say to him, huh?
Thank you, Papa.
Well, happy past, huh?
I'm looking for Dorathy. My name is Bobo.
Oh. How are you?
Fine, ma. Please, is Dorathy at home? I have a letter for her.
No, she's not at home. Dorathy just went out about 20 minutes ago with the mother. No, you can give me the letter. I'll give it to her when she comes back. Don't worry. She told me everything.
Okay, ma. I just wanted to see her again. Please, if she comes back, give her this letter. My picture is inside. And tell her I want to get her own picture too.
I will do just that.
Okay, ma.
Take care of yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Bye. Bye. Young love. White like fire. Just like this. I don't know if I have to be.
Dear Dorothy, how is your new school? Are the teachers good to you? I gaze at the place you used to sit in our class every day, and I wonder if you think of me as I think of you. Be a good girl and always read your books. Remember what teacher Mickey used to tell us, that the man or woman we shall be in future depends on the boy or girl we are today. Find a way to send me your picture to you. You can hide it by the left corner of your gate. I shall take it from there. Finally, I don't know if this letter will reach you. I am writing it before I come out of the house in case I don't meet you at home. But I know that somehow it will reach you. I am bold now because my father spoke to me again this morning. He talked about you and I was very happy.
He told me to always let my feet move with my heart. That is what I'm telling you to. Always let your feet move with your heart. Until we find each other again. Smiles from Bobo.
One second, let me be, you know, done with my breakfast.
Okay,
I'm going to Mercy. Kitchen is
kitchen. Alright, I'm Mercy. I'm Mercy. I'm ready for school. Mommy.
Hmm?
Are you ready
though? Almost. Practically. Alright, Mercy. Mercy.
Mama.
I'm going out, so come and clear the table. And make sure you don't forget to make my pepper soup for me.
Yes, Mother.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, Mother.
Oh, bye-bye. Mother,
bye-bye.
Bye.
Bobo?
Bobo?
How are you?
Fine, Mother.
Dorothy said I should give you this letter. And a picture in it.
Okay, thank you, Mama. Is Dorothy alright?
She was very happy this morning. I guess your letter made her happy.
Bobo.
Right now we're treating lexical compounds. Lexical compounds. What are lexical compounds? Lexical compounds are those words that are joined, two words that are joined together to form one word. It could be a verb and a noun. It could be an adverb and a noun joined together to form one word. It could even be a noun and a noun joined together to form one word. For example, we have preschool. Preschool, pre and school, they are two different words. They are now being joined together to form one word called preschool. Now we have antenatal. Anti is an adverb, while natal is a noun. They are joined together to form one word. We have crossroads. Cross is a verb. Road is a noun. Cross and road are now joined together to form one word. We also have other examples like bilateral, postmortem, football. There are a lot of other examples which this board cannot contain, but I want anybody that can give us more examples of lexical compounds. You at the back.
Blackboard.
Blackboard, correct. Clap for him. The boy behind him. Bobo. Bobo is your first. Stand up. Give us, what was I saying? What was the last thing? You were not paying attention. You were busy writing. Copy of what we are writing. Something fell. What was that fell? Bring it here. What are you writing in my class?
This is a picture.
Is this not the picture of Dorothy that has changed school?
Yes.
And what is this you have at the back? Dorothy, my love. Dorothy, my love. So you turned my class into a love class. I was busy teaching, you were busy writing a love letter. Her mother must hear this. You all call him lover boy.
Lover boy.
Again.
Lover boy.
Tell him shame.
Shame.
Tell him shame.
Shame.
Tell him go back to your feet. Shamefully go back to your seat.
Shamefully go back to your seat.
Now, I'm taking this off. Dorothy, go back to your seat. Dorothy's mother must hear this. You have turned my class to love letter. So let's continue with our class. We have, somebody just mentioned blackboard. Let's add it to our examples.
Mercy! Mercy! Mercy, where are you?
Madam, I'm here.
What is it? You say I am angry, tired, and frustrated.
Over what, madam?
Despite all my efforts to keep Dorothy and Bobo apart,
She'll still find a way to exchange love letters and snapshots with each other. Look at this. Just look at this. Bobo's teachers caught him admiring his snapshot while lessons were going on. Just see, her teacher at her former school invited and told me. We all questioned him, but despite our pressure, this boy adamantly refused to say how he and Dorothy still managed to communicate with each other. Anyway, the teacher has, the school has given him up until tomorrow to reveal who the person is or face a 2-week suspension or maybe expulsion.
Madam, I did it. Yes, the poor boy doesn't have to suffer to protect me. I'm the one that they give their letters and I pass it on to the other person.
You. Mercy. Mercy, you! Why? Why, Mercy, why? Have I ever done anything wrong to you? Don't I pay your salaries on time?
You do.
Don't I treat you like my sister?
You do.
Oh, Mercy, why? Mercy, why would you want to ruin my only child? The only child I have? Why?
Madam, you see, they are growing. They are developing. Every child passes through this stage one way or the other. I think it's wicked denying them the innocence and the innocent ways of love that are written in those letters. Madam, excuse me. Didn't you write love letters when you were at her age? Or didn't anybody write any love letter to you? It is a childish thing. I think children should be allowed to be children, or else they get like children when they are adults.
Look, madam, I read these letters before passing it to them.
We still have control in whatever they are doing, so we can still control them when it starts getting out of hand. Please, madam.
You know, I have a good mind to suck you. I really have a good mind to suck you.
Please, madam.
Give me that. You know what? I am putting you in the only daughter. I'm going to one school. If you want to go to your parents.
Please, Mama, come on. Come on.
You don't look happy. Huh? You're in a bad mood. Did anything go wrong at school?
Papa, I just got the bad news that Dorothy has been changed to a boarding school in a faraway area. I'm not gonna see her again.
No malaria.
Thank God.
No typhoid or any disease. We can start running a test on her. Well, she shows signs of severe stress and depression, which I must say is strange considering her age. So I would suggest whenever she is discharged, she should get lots of rest.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you so much. So, when is she likely to be discharged?
Well, pretty soon, at most tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
We want to watch over her response throughout the night. Yeah. So she'll be all right.
Thank you very much, doctor.
Thank you.
I was so distressed, you know. Thank you. So thank you. All right.
Well.
Time I've heard her call that name in her sleep. Who is Bobo?
Bobo.
Yeah.
I don't know. Ask her. Okay.
Madam. Does your daughter have any friend or relative who she is very much attached to by name Bobo?
None that I know of, doctor. Why do you ask?
Whatever that name means, she's been repeating that name whenever she is asleep. In cases like hers, it is always good to try every avenue Maybe see if we can find who Bobo is. Bring him to her. I tell you, she may start getting well.
Doctor, have you asked who Bobo is?
I've sent a friendly note to ask her, but she won't say anything. She cries and says nothing. In fact, I am worried.
On no account should the nurses and doctor be made to know that Bobo exists. Do I make myself clear? Do I make myself clear,
Messi? Yes, madam.
This nonsense must stop. Dorothy is in hospital already. Let her throw her tantrums and forget about that thing called Bobo once and for all. You hear me?
Tenderly grows, destined to be close to each other. Our love is wide like fire, admires each other, ready to die for each other. Shares our problems, shares our heartbreaks. Nothing can separate our love, only if our feet move with our hearts. We'll be together in love. Is dark. I love you from my heart. You're my rain when it's dry. You're the one my heart desires. We're made for each other. I love you from my heart. You are the love of my other. Our love is wide like fire, admires each other, ready to die for each other. Shares our problems, shares our heartbreaks. Nothing can separate our love, only if our feet move with our hearts. We'll be together in love.
I love you, I love you. You're my moon when it loves you.
From getting too bad. And all she kept saying is that name Bobo. Now listen to me. It will be in your interest to tell me who the Bobo is, or else the blood of your daughter will be on your head.
Thank you.
my mother hates me. Because of that, she put me in a false school in boarding house.
Where I can never see him again. I want to go back to my former school where all my friends and Bobo are.
It's all right. I'll talk to your mother. Okay? Be fine.
Satisfy my curiosity. Did you charm my daughter?
Charm? I don't even know what charm looks like.
Please, Osita, hurry up, okay?
Once a foolish man who could not drink good water. He got it from a dirty pond and gave his wife and daughter. Now he starts weeping, weeping, weeping. Now he starts weeping. Oh, my wife and daughter. Oh, my wife and daughter. Dear. Dorothy, how are you?
I'm fine. Hi.
I'm fine, I'm fine.
I thought I'd be able to see you.
Me too, Dorothy. Me too. Got it from a dirty pond and gave his wife and daughter. Now he starts weeping, weeping, weeping. Now he starts weeping. Oh, my wife and daughter. Oh, my wife and daughter. There was once a foolish man who could not drink good water. He got it from a dirty pond and gave his wife and daughter. Now he starts weeping, weeping, weeping. Now he starts weeping. Oh, my wife and daughter. Oh, my wife and daughter. There was once a foolish man who could not drink good water. He got it from a dirty pond and gave his wife and daughter. Now he starts weeping, weeping, weeping. Now he starts weeping. Oh, my wife and daughter. Oh, my wife and daughter.
Madam Ezenwa, could you believe that when I checked your daughter's temperature this morning, it dropped to normal? All the fever is gone. In fact, if she keep on improving like this at the end of the day, we shall be sending her home tomorrow morning.
So, Bobo was the problem.
Children are like that sometimes. Severe sadness can lead to depression and trauma. And I tell you, they are deadly. Let your daughter be happy. Put her back in her former school, amongst her old friends, and close to Bobo. Then keep an eye over their friendship.
All right, thank you very much, Doctor. God bless you. Let me go and see that. God bless you.
Class, can any person tell me why we refer to these as general literary terms? Anybody? Yes, you.
The reason why we refer to these as general literary terms is that
they are noticeable in three branches of literature, which are drama, poetry, and prose.
A round of applause for her. What she's saying is that they cut across three basic what? Branches in literature, known to be what? Prose, drama, and what?
Poetry.
Now, let us go to them. Number one, what do we have?
Stroke.
Number two,
plus.
Number three,
plus.
Number four,
sexy.
Five,
Dition.
Six.
Dition.
Now let's take it again. One, two, three, four, five,
Dition.
And six.
Dition.
Now let's go to number one, T. This is simply the major message a writer puts across to what? The reader. I repeat again.
Good morning, class.
So, class, what do we say to our friend? I want all of you to say, welcome back to class, our friend Dorathy.
Welcome back to class, our friend Dorathy.
You are not serious. Will you say that thing very well?
Welcome back to class, our friend Dorathy.
Beautiful.
Good students. So, we go back to plot. We can define them as follows. Number one, what?
Storyline.
Number two,
cause and issues.
Three,
sequential arrangement of events.
Four, you. What did I say? Number four.
What is number four?
A manner with which a writer narrates his story.
A manner with which a writer narrates.
You better be very careful. Now we go to characterization. This is simply the development of characters
that the rivers of Babylon, 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 and the bees.
Babylon, Babylon, Babylon,
and the rivers.
Babylon, Babylon, Babylon,
they will remember.
Babylon, Babylon, Babylon,
that the rivers.
Let's go, let's go.
Babylon, Babylon.
And where we fall.
Babylon, Babylon.
And there we fall.
Babylon, Babylon, Babylon.
All right, let's go.
Babylon,
Babylon, Babylon, Babylon.
And let the beacon.
Babylon, Babylon, Babylon. We die out of us.
Shout
woo-hoo. And we sing the last song. In our
strength. Let's go.
Dark.
You are the Lord.